Coastal Carolina University scientists have developed a viral test for COVID-19.
The reality is for right now, we need this here.
The test was developed in the lab by Michelle Barthay.
I was asked to develop a new testing methodology that may increase productivity or efficiency of the testing that's going on, and that's what I've done.
Professor Paul Richardson is handling the next step.
I'm the person that is now at the Conway Medical Center running the samples to see how effective it is.
If proven to be effective and then certified, the test will be used at Conway Medical Center to tell whether a person has the virus.
This is fantastic. Anything we can do to, you know, better the cause and to really help our patients, hopefully long term, we're all about.
Expectations for the test are high.
We do a lot of internal controls to actually show that the tests will work.
It's seems to be fairly effective from based on the internal testing that we can do at this point in time.
Accuracy is the key.
I would like to see over 95% effective. But I'd, of course, like to see better than that. But I think 95 is a good benchmark to shoot for.
Various factors make it impossible to tell how long it will take to complete the validation phase.
It really depends on how many positive samples we get and how accurate the test is.
We're going to go ahead and do your COVID-19 testing.
Sample collection was designed to be less invasive than the nasal swab currently in use.
Instead of sticking a swab up someone's nasal cavity, we're actually just using a plastic tip on their tongue.
It's very simple, it's very easy, it has no pain, nothing, just touch the tongue. You get your saliva, which has been found to be one of the most effective ways to identify the virus.
Samples for the validation phase are being collected from consenting patients at Conway Medical Center.
Anything that would get as good or better results, but be a whole lot more comfortable and easy to do, is preferable.
At the moment, test results at Conway Medical Center are received in 24 to 48 hours. The CCU test can produce results for 28 samples in an hour and 15 minutes.
Dr. Barthay is currently working at CCU on another methodology, using different techniques, which should allow us to triple our productivity.
Which again, I think, from my perspective, will be a game changer for what we need to do in terms of testing.
Increased efficiency in testing can reveal more about the prevalence of the virus on the local level.
Ultimately, I really hope that we can provide our community a better sense of security.
Coastal was called upon to develop a more efficient test.
I was pretty confident we had individuals who could at least conceptualize what we could do. Of course, the key issue is could they actually put something together.
CCU scientists did the work even while continuing their instructional duties.
It's been a lot of long nights and not too much sleep.
But my thought was if this can help people, then it's worth doing it.
Creating this test shows what is possible at Coastal.
We have some extremely top-notch scientists here.
In terms of their abilities and their capabilities in the laboratory, they are every bit as good as someone you'd find at a major research center.
I think it's going to be a surprise to a lot of people hearing about the kind of sciences we are doing here at Coastal.
This also draws attention to the way that Coastal and Conway Medical Center are working together.
It was really easy for us because we already do have a relationship with them.
The collaboration's been awesome. I mean, this has been seamless. Working with Dr. Richardson and all the folks at Coastal's been great.
This project received the full backing of the university.
All the university officials were immediately came with a yes when I mentioned that we wanted to do this.
Funding has come primarily from grants, with the machine that actually tests the samples paid for with alumni gifts.
So the alumni of Coastal Carolina University have played a very important role in this overall project.
As far as the development of tests for the area,
no one is forcing us to do this. No one is demanding we do it. We're doing it because we feel a sense of pride in our community and we want to be there to help our community.
CCU is not finished.
As a scientist, we are always trying to refine and tweak and improve.
Barthay is working on a single-step, single-temperature test that can be used by individuals in the same way as home pregnancy tests.